Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.6 Developer Beta 2. This was a bit of a surprise since iOS 13.5.5 was the last beta, but Apple has again renamed their beta to now 13.6 Developer Beta 2. Now, this is out to all developers and soon to public beta testers. It could be out by the time you're watching this video, but if it's not today, it will be later tomorrow, most likely. Now, this came in at 336.6 megabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. It was anywhere from 150 megabytes on the iPad Air 2 to the iPhone 6S Plus, which was about 150 megabytes as well. Now, let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 17G5045C, and this particular update, like I said, was a little bit of a surprise, but is a couple builds away from probably the last or final build where it will be released to the public. So we'll talk more about when we should expect this to be released a little bit later, but also Apple released tvOS 13.4.8 beta as well as macOS 10.15.6 beta 2. This particular update also has no modem update. So if you're having issues with LTE or Wi-Fi, that should be no different than the previous builds. Now, in this particular build, the notes did add a couple new features, or at least they mentioned one and they've resolved another. So we'll talk about the features in just a second. But the first thing is they resolved an issue where the home screen web app support data uses URLs as expected. So this issue is fixed. If you were having issue with the home screen web apps, maybe that you have to go to a web app link and it wasn't working properly, that should be fixed now. Now, as far as new features, there are a couple things in this. So one of them, it's very minor, but if you go into your settings, like you were checking for a software update, if you go to software update, you now can go to customize automatic updates, and you also have a couple options now. So if I turn this on to download iOS updates, it will install them automatically if I turn this switch on. So to give you an idea what it looked like before, if you're not familiar with that, if I bring in the iPhone XR, you'll see that under automatic updates, you just had a toggle for on and off. Now you have a toggle to download it or install it or turn off both. So that's a nice little feature that they've added there. And it's just something new. I keep them both off because I like to check them manually. Now they did add something else new in health. So if we go into the health app, and I think I put it in here. There we go. In the health app, you'll see here's my summary, but we go to browse, we have a new section now, and the new section is called symptoms. And so if you use this to track things, anything from hearing, I use that with my Apple Watch to measure decibels in the room to see how loud it was. You'll see in the past 12 months, there was a noise notification. Well, if you use it for how you're feeling with respiratory or maybe sleep, now you have symptoms. So it's got everything from acne to bloating to chills, congestion, heartburn, loss of smell. And this is to help you remember what was going on in the past, maybe keep it for future records. And you can use this. You don't have to use it, of course. And it's not in previous builds. Now, as you can see on the iPhone XR, symptoms isn't there on the previous version of iOS 13.5.1. So this is something exclusive to 13.6. And you can see symptoms are there. So if we go into chills, for example, we can pick the day and then talk about the symptoms and things like that. So we can add data, we hit add data, and we can say present, mild, moderate, or severe chills, when it started and when it ended. So if you want to keep track of all those things, or maybe a doctor asked you to do that, same with heartburn. Again, the same thing, present, mild, moderate, severe, and your time and date. And it explains each one of them. So nausea, again, it explains what it is. You can add it to favorites, show all data if you have data. And of course, it tells you about data access as well. So you can allow zero access. You can allow some access to research studies and or none at all. It's all up to you. So that's something that's completely new in this particular update. Now, there is nothing else new as far as features. And I would expect that's because iOS 14 is right around the corner. We'll talk more about that in a moment. But let's take a look at the battery life that I had on the previous beta, because some people are saying it's great. Others are saying it's not. And I currently have 98% battery health. And my battery health has stayed that way for, well, more than 6 months at this point. So that's pretty good. Now we'll take a look at the last 10 days. Maybe yesterday was 3 hours. I use my phone some of the time, and then I use an iPad or a Mac. But for example, here's 2 hours and 48 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 17 minutes of screen off time. And as you can see here, I'm using less than 50% of my battery life. If you combine all of this time together, you're going to get about 10 to 12 hours of screen on time on the 11 Pro Max. It can vary depending on the device. Now, in the little time that I've used this, performance seems to be pretty good. I haven't had any complaints so far. I haven't seen a single lockup, and I would expect that to be pretty good with this beta, and I'll show you the benchmarks in a moment. Now, as far as performance on the iPhone 6S Plus, which is one of the older devices, I did open Minecraft. It's sort of a benchmark that I use to see how it is in general. We'll wait for it to load here, and we're in. So it resumed, no problems here, and it seems to be working well. So if we walk along, you'll see that the frame rates are pretty decent, no issues, and it loads and resumes fast. Now, I know some people were having issues with RAM management. I would expect that to be pretty good here, but only time will tell. Most people are not complaining about it at all with 13.5.1 or the betas. Now, with iPadOS, there's not really anything new as well. You've got the same exact features that I've mentioned already. So again, if I go into Settings, General Software Update, you'll see that we have the same features as well. So there's nothing new specific to the iPad, but it does gain the same features and should have similar performance as we're having on this update. Now let's take a look at the Geekbench scores. Now I'm using Geekbench 5, and I actually ran it a couple times because at first I got pretty low numbers, and usually after it's done doing things in the background, it will speed up. So you'll see I have 1,327 for single core, 3,356 for multi-core. That's pretty good considering what we had before. So if we take a look at the history and we scroll down to June 9th, and there's June 1st. So this should give you an idea. We're very close as far as the single core versus multi-core. We're a little bit higher on both this time around. So that's a pretty good sign. But in general, expect similar results on all of these devices compared to what you had before. Now let's take a look at all of them so you can compare your devices with what I have. Now on the left, I have the iPad Air 2. Then we have the iPhone 6S Plus and then the iPhone 11 Pro Max. So this should give you a general idea of how it should be performing. And if it's pretty low, try it a little bit later and it will probably bump up to where you would expect it or even better. Now, as far as iOS 13.6's release date, well, I would give that a few more weeks. In fact, we should see iOS 14 on the 22nd with iOS 14 Beta 1 being released to developers. And that's if Apple continues to do what they've done in the past. So expect it on even the iPhone 6S Plus or 6S from what people are saying. But we'll have to wait and see if that holds true. Now, also expect iOS 13.6 maybe sometime in July. Usually Apple will go through a few versions of it and then come out with a final one, and they'll continue to develop iOS 13.6 until iOS 14 is released in the fall or autumn. So expect iOS 14 maybe around September or October, depending on when the iPhone 12 launches. So that's it with this particular update. If you found anything else new, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.